In 1936 and 1938, severe flooding crippled the city of Hartford, Connecticut. To prevent future floods, the city leaders of the time decided to bury the river.
So they had started to bury the river, and then they realized they want to have a highway that goes through the city of Hartford, because all great new cities have highways, right? So they built two highways. They built one highway going up along the Connecticut River and another highway going through the city, and they buried the Park River at that time, right? And they buried the confluence of the north and south branches of the Park River. Nevertheless, the north and the south branches of the Park River pop out of these conduit systems. So many people think the river is buried in the city of Hartford now, and that's one of the biggest misconceptions, is that there isn't a river in the city of Hartford. But in fact, there's these two beautiful branches, the north and the south branches of the Park River.
The Park River Watershed Revitalization Initiative has partnered with Park River Arts to bring art and science together. Founded by university professors, Park River Arts works to illustrate the relation of art, landscape, and urban design to water quality and cultural sustainability.
They understand eco art, and they see the eco art movement as a very meaningful movement in art. And so we're mixing together some of the science and heritage and art to sort of raise awareness. As we repair the fabric, we uncover this history. Because parts of it have been admittedly lost, we have opportunity for reinterpretation or sort of revitalization, which I see as kind of breathing art and new life into fundamental principles of urban life. So it's a great place to be.
Members of the Park River Watershed Revitalization Initiative believe that investing in the landscape of the watershed will draw people to savor the beauty of Hartford rather than just pass through it on the highway.
I think the 21st century environmental movement is going to be about the revitalization of nature in the city. What we accomplished in the 20th century was the protection. We recognize the value of protecting our natural resources. But now through design, through the design process, we can revitalize and improve upon the way that we live with nature.